it's an insidious, relentless disease that has been hard to crack. And I believe society and the United States as a whole has made a lot of advancements in recovering from addiction. I believe that society views addiction today much more so as a disease than, you know, 40 years ago it was a moral deficiency. And today in some people's mind it's still a moral deficiency. And today we know that it is a disease and it's very deadly.
Greg grew up in a broken home and was exposed to drugs at a young age. However, just as his life was taking a turn for the worse, Greg realized his prison sentence for dealing drugs was necessary to exit the deadly path he was on.
The reason I feel it's important to do is being of service to God and others is one of the things that helps me maintain my stability. And it keeps me grounded. And it keeps me humble. You know, and it's paramount for my own success in life and in recovery and is being of service to others. And the desire to do so is deep-seated. Addiction knows no face. It will ruin your life and kill you, regardless of your financial means, your status in the community, your status in life. You know, addiction is not prejudice.
10 years later, Greg received a presidential pardon. He then invested his time and resources with the Avera Addiction Care Center to help people through their experiences along the way to recovery.
If I can recover from this, anybody can, because no one thought I could, and I didn't think I could, and I'm doing okay today, you know, right now. And I think the best thing that I tell them is that there's hope for this, that this disease can be arrested at some point and recovery is then possible. And because when families or addicts come to me, what they don't have is hope. And that was one of the funnest things about being part of building the Avera Addiction Center, is we had that conversation that we want to bring hope to our clients as they come in.